Ever feel like your brain needs a jump start? We all might feel that way from time to time, but actually, brain stimulation has been used for years to treat chronic pain and depression. It's known to be a safe alternative, yet until now, it's mostly been done manually, which means results can be spotty. Today, I'm getting my brain zapped by Aina Terva to learn how a new technology can find the optimal stimulation for any human brain in a matter of seconds.
Kate, are you ready?
I am ready.
It doesn't sound like much. And to be honest, it doesn't feel like much more than a finger gently flicking my head. But these clicks are sending pulses straight to my brain. How exactly does it work?
This stimulation coil, it also has markers, so we can follow in real time where do we stimulate with respect to the anatomical brain image. We create an electric field in the brain, so where would be the maximum place of that?
Right now, when doctors use transcranial brain stimulation, they need to search for the right spot by trial and error, manually moving the device around your head. This prototype has two coils that, paired with a powerful algorithm, can automatically adjust in real time to find the right stimulation orientation.
We stimulate your brain, and at the same time, we record your brain activity. So we measure what happens right after stimulation in your brain. And based on those brain responses, the algorithm decides in which way we would like to stimulate next.
You gave me 30 pulses, and this is the 30th.
So what we see that there is a high peak a few tens of milliseconds after the stimulus. But what you can also see that the signal is very noisy. So our algorithm has to handle noisy signal, which makes this challenging.
So this is what's best for me?
Yeah, those 30 pulses showed that the optimal orientation on that area would be this red arrow.
And it took us about 1 minute to gather that data. And what strikes me about this is that this is clearly much smarter and much faster than any human operator could possibly be.
Yeah, I couldn't operate, my brain couldn't do all the computations it does.
Dr. Celia Valda has used this kind of brain stimulation in her medical practice for years. She says that while there's still research to be done, the new technique could one day mean that patients can be treated faster and more effectively.
When we give several pulses repeatedly, we can affect to neurons and especially how they communicate with each other. So we can change synaptic function. Synapses are between neurons, and we can increase synaptic efficacy or decrease it so that the communication is somehow like stronger or weaker between neurons.
What kind of diseases or disorders can you treat with this?
We can treat depression and also pain, especially patients who suffer neuropathic pain.
Patients like these sometimes suffer from severe side effects from drug treatments, which makes drug-free options vital. Other times, brain stimulation can be an add-on to boost relief. With automized brain stimulation, the ultimate goal is to bring a better quality of life to more patients more reliably.
It's faster, but it's more reliable. There is not so much changes based on that who is doing the mapping. Is it you or me? Now when we have this automatic system, we can trust that a little bit more, so it's more accurate.